Hello and welcome to the Vaults of Terra. My name is Ed and today we will be having a look at the Imperium, specifically a look at the Primaris Space Marines. Appearing with the resurrection of Primarch Rebute Guilliman, the Primaris Space Marines are a new type of transhuman combatant to join the armies of the Imperium, and they are a breed of Space Marine not directly created by the Emperor himself, though they are based on his work. The Primaris Space Marines were in fact developed by Tech Priest Archmagos Dominus Belisarius Call, who received orders directly from Guilliman before his attempted assassination and stasis for 10,000 years. He was required to redesign and perfect the Space Marine program that the Emperor had finished in haste during the Great Crusade. In the 10 millennia since they began, Call and his Tech Priests have worked diligently to create this new legion. The purpose of the Primaris was to be strong enough to beat back the Chaos Marines created during the Horus Heresy, a difficult task for the Astartes who already existed. Guilliman knew that Chaos would never stop trying to destroy the Imperium, and that they would one day need warriors that surpassed even his father's creations to defend the Imperium. Now, 10,000 years later, the next step of the Astartes has arrived. They have been engineered to be larger, stronger, and faster than even regular Astartes, providing a new edge over the ancient Chaos Marines, and able to begin taking back the Great Rift that now divides the Imperium in two. Unlike their Astartes brethren, the Primaris were kept in stasis until they grew into their new gene-forged frames, with some having been in stasis nearly 10,000 years as their numbers were built up by Call. Some of the Primaris Marines even recall seeing the Primarchs themselves before their time in stasis. They were also provided with new arms and armor forged by the Mechanicus for their enhanced frames. They wear Mk. 10 Tacticus power armor, which upgrades the Mk. 7 power armor worn by most current Astartes and is more modular. There are two known patterns of Mk. 10, which are the Gravis, a heavier pattern of power armor for greater protection, and the Riva, a lighter pattern that allows for greater movement and is almost completely silent when active. Their weapons are the Mk. 2 Call Pattern Bolt Rifle, a more powerful and accurate long-range bolt gun, along with more specialist weapons like the Mk. 3 Belisarius Pattern Plasma Incinerator, an upgraded plasma gun which can avoid overheating unless it's used on its highest settings. The Primaris Marines began their service at the beginning of the Indomitus Crusade, led by Guilliman himself to retake the sections of the Imperium overrun by Chaos in this 13th Black Crusade. Some of the Primaris Marines were formed into new chapters in an event known as the Ultima Founding, following the Codex Astartes setup. Other Primaris Marines were offered to the existing chapters to bolster their strength and numbers. Whilst many chapters have welcomed these new Marines, others opposed their creation, with some even being hostile to the new Primaris Marines, seeing them as a corruption of the Emperor's work meddled with by mere mortals, even if their creator was over 10,000 years old. Despite their newly engineered nature, the Primaris Marines can still trace their gene seed back to the first founding of the Astartes, and each Primaris Marine is a scion of the 9 loyal Primarchs from the time of the Horus Heresy. In addition to the 19 organs provided to the Astartes, the Primaris Marines have another 3 organs designed to increase their power and combat the corrupting effects of Chaos, although this aspect has yet to be seen. These Primaris organs are the Sinew Coils, aka the Steel Within, the Magnificant, aka the Amplifier, and the Belsarian Furnace, otherwise known as the Revitalizer. The Sinew Coils are implants that places dura-metallic coils directly beneath the skin, allowing incredible contraction of the muscles and sinews for a massive boost in strength along with extra protection. The Magnificant is a thumb-sized lobe inserted into the Primaris Marine's brain which releases more growth hormone and increases the functionality of the other gene seed organs. It is based on half of the Immortus gland which was created for the Primarchs, allowing for their massive size and durability. Unfortunately, only materials for one half of the gland remained, with materials for the other half completely purged from the Imperial archives, either by the Emperor or some dark source, which Call was unable to discover. Finally, the Belisarian Furnace is a dormant organ between the Primaris Marines' hearts. In times where the body is under extreme stress or trauma, it will blurt out chemicals into the bloodstream, a concoction that is simulated combat stims to allow for normal movement function and pain deadening, whilst also aiding in rapid regrowth of tissue, bone, and muscle. Once it activates, it takes time to create more chemicals, so repeated extreme trauma can still overwhelm a Primaris Marine. The newer chapters have been provided with homeworlds along the Great Rift through the Imperium, although others have been provided with fortress monasteries of chapters that have been destroyed in the last 10,000 years of war. Their homeworlds are in some of the most intense combat zones in the Imperium, allowing these new Marines to cut their teeth on the greatest challenges to provide them with much-needed experience they will need to help retake the Imperium. As Guilliman's crusade advanced, his fleet was augmented by Kahl's own fleet that accompanied a mech-arch ship that contained a huge number of Primaris Marines still in stasis, ready to reinforce the crusade if faced with future losses. The crusade eventually fought on Rin's world, reinforcing the Crimson Fists, providing them with new Primaris Marines. They also reinforced the White Scars and lately the Blood Angels, who were also fighting in the devastation of Baal against High Fleet Leviathan. As the crusade's momentum began to break down, and the holds of the Mech-Arch were emptied, Kahl left the crusade to finish his part of the Ultima Founding. However, thanks to backup from the Primaris Marines chapters returning from their new homeworlds to consolidate the crusade's gains, they helped maintain the front that Guilliman had created against the Black Crusade. Along with the new chapters and reinforcements for existing chapters, half of the new Primaris Marines were also placed in a new formation known as the Unnumbered Sons of the Primarchs, or just the Unnumbered Sons. Also called the Grey Shields amongst themselves, these are 9 legion-sized armies descended from the 9 Loyalist Primarchs. They wear the armour of their original chapters and work in chapter-sized groups, but work in mixed formations and squads, allowing for the mixed gene lines of Guilliman's brothers to work closely together, fostering understanding and preventing the differences in ideology that caused the rifts between the Primarchs during the Great Crusade. As their numbers were depleted, the Unnumbered Sons also began to split apart into new chapters on Guilliman's orders, to help maintain their fighting structure without relying on the 9 original formations created at the start of this crusade. Once the crusade ended, the formations and the Primaris Marines that remained broke into individual chapters or returned to help reinforce their founding chapters along with the other Primaris brothers. One worry, especially for chapters like the Blood Angels and Space Wolves, now the Primaris Marines are creating their own chapters or rejoining their parents' chapters, is that their new improved brethren might discover the dark flaws in their gene seed. These flaws had apparently been stabilized or removed from the new Marines with a genetic deficiency rate of only 0.001%, making them almost immune to genetic flaw. However, time will tell if this remains true as the Primaris Marines continue their service. So that's everything I wanted to mention today. Thank you for watching the video on the Primaris Marines and their integration into the Imperium. That next time we will be having another look at Chaos, so I hope you will join me for that. Anyway, thank you for watching today. See you next time on the Vaults of Terra.